When we talk about algorithms, we are interested in their performance. But instead of expressing an algorithm's performance in seconds or minutes, we use Big O notation. Big O notation classifies algorithms according to how their running time or space requirements grow as the input size grows. Or in other words, it tells us how an algorithm scales. We have few common complexities: constant, linear, logarithmic, linearithmic, quadratic, exponential, and factorial. Those complexities can be visualized with following graph. As you can see, with complexities like quadratic, exponential, or factorial, the requirements for time or space can rise quite rapidly. Let's say we have an array with some random numbers. Now we would like to access 21st item. It doesn't matter if our array contains 10 items or 10,000. It will always perform with constant complexity. If someone asks, "Hey, is there number 17 in your array?" To find out, we have to go through all of the numbers, and therefore the complexity is linear. Okay, now let's sort our array using bubble sort, which is the perfect example of quadratic complexity. Since our array is now sorted, we can do binary search. Let's find number 9046. Binary search is cutting data in half each iteration, which gives us logarithmic complexity. Big O notation assumes the worst possible scenario. This guarantees that algorithm will never take more space or time above the limit. Big O notation is sometimes used with combination of two other notations: Big Omega, which stands for best case scenario, and Big Theta, which stands for average case scenario. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like this in the future.